Hey, this is Joey Cape, and playing the slide bar tonight with my new band, Bad Loud. Should be pretty fun. I've just now got two new records that just came out. One was a split acoustic record, a split called, it's a really great title. It's called Acoustic Volume 2. It's a bad title. With Tony Sly and myself, and I'm about to go out on tour with him, but all like East Coast states in July and August, which is really not smart because it's going to be awful and hot. And this band, the Bad Loud Band, our record, I mean, we just got it. There's no release because there's no label, but we're selling it at the shows. And so I got like four other bands and they're all doing stuff too. I'm not going to talk about all of them because it starts to sound ridiculous. Well, you know, we talked a lot about collaborating and working together because we did another one back in 2004 and we didn't collaborate at all on that. And we did a bunch of touring together the last few years and we thought, well, we know like all, you know, we know each other's songs. We play together the whole time. And we just thought, okay, this time we're going to do it right. We're going to go in the same studio, record together, collaborate, the whole thing. And we ended up not doing any collaborating. Schedules. It always comes down to schedules. And the ridiculous thing is that at one point, I didn't know he was recording. I was recording at my house. And he called me. He's like, hey, man, can you get in? And I'm like, I got 2 days left to finish this thing. Where are you? And he was 5 minutes away from my house in a different studio. I think most musicians are inherently kind of lazy people. It's part of the reason that they end up being musicians and they have a poor work ethic, and most people get into music and that kind of thing for a different reason than I did. I never wanted to tour. I just like writing music and I like being in the studio. When you have a band, if you treat it like a gig and you think you confuse loyalty for not having anything else in your life but that one thing, if you treat it that way, then you have so much downtime. And if you don't smoke pot, there's nothing to do. My solution to that idle time was just to form other bands or do other projects. But I think at the end of the day, it should be that way because it is an art. You're supposed to be making it. You're supposed to be creating. You know, I don't think people who paint or write or do any of the other kinds of the arts sit around when, you know, they don't. It's not like they just schedule to do collaborations with one person over and over and over again. It almost doesn't make sense. Holding out to work with John Lennon would be killer. Jimi Hendrix? No, I don't. No, I mean, of course. I mean, you know, I don't even, where do I start? Any, you know, songwriter that I appreciate, I would love to work with, and there are too many to name, you know. It's a great thing to work with other people playing music because it automatically adds diversity to what you do, and it's what I do is pretty one-dimensional. So when I work with other people, it seems a little bit more interesting, I think. I think I kind of got to go play, actually. So see you later.